Welcome to worship. My name is Shannon White, and I am the pastor here at Wilton Presbyterian Church. We are a welcoming and inclusive congregation, and we are so glad that you are here. On this Sunday, we honor our graduating seniors, those who have completed high school and college. And even though there is much pain and struggle in the world and even in the country and in our town right now, we felt it was important to continue on with the celebration of their achievements. So we will be having some conversation about our world situation, but we also will spend the majority of the service focusing on our graduates. So congratulations to Patrick, Lindsay, Carl, Anna, and James for having completed high school, and to Tucker, John, and Anna for having graduated from college. Later in the service, we'll be celebrating the Lord's Supper, as you can see here, so you may want to pause the videotape for a moment, or pause the YouTube channel and get a piece of bread or something similar, and a cup of something to drink, and we will celebrate together. Before we begin our call to worship, let me first say that I was very moved this past Tuesday for the gathering here in Wilton of our community, our WPC community, and our broader community for a walk for peace and an end to racism. And it was quite moving. There were over 400 people there, although the police say around 800. I don't know, somewhere in between that number. As people came together and people's voices were heard, it was quite a moving time. There are many of you who came. There were many of you who were not able to come because of the pandemic. And there were some who did not agree that we participated in such an event during the middle of this pandemic. The reality is everyone is right. And so we come together with differing views, united, as we come together in worship. The faithful road and choose the way of God's justice. We are here because we strongly believe that our God is good and that we live in that goodness. We are here to proclaim our faith and to seek direction along this faith journey. Let us come together then to be God's people. Even though scattered in our homes, we unite in spirit as one. Let us worship God. Let us pray. God of the sojourners, we ask yet again for an assurance of your presence with us on our journey in these days. Keep us from helpless despair. Give us the power to make your love known and experienced so all may know that we are made in your image, that we are all connected, that we indeed are all one. Amen. Our scripture reading this morning comes from the gospel and will be read by Margaret Carkner, who's one of our deacons. Margaret.
Let us pray. Lord, open our hearts and minds by the power of your Holy Spirit, that we may hear your words with joy. The reading for today is found in the New Testament from the book of Matthew. It is chapter 28, verses 16 through 20. Now the 11 disciples went to Galilee, to the mountain to which Jesus had directed them. When they saw him, they worshiped him, but some doubted. And Jesus came and said to them, "All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, and teaching them to obey everything that I have commanded you. And remember, I am with you always to the end of the age. Here ends the reading.
Julie Fowler, our co-director of Family Ministries for grades 6 through 12, will bring us a word for our graduates, followed by messages from high school students Kathryn Stein, Maggie and Shannon Rowe, and then Jessica Jones will bring us the prayers of the people this morning.
Good morning. Wilton Presbyterian Church has a long-standing tradition we call High School Senior Sunday. This energized service is led by our seniors as they finish their high school portion of their lifelong journey of faith. This year, in lieu of our Senior Sunday in the sanctuary, it was decided to dedicate this service, an honoring of you, our high school graduates, as you have endured, sacrificed, and navigated with grace circumstances placed before you this past spring. You are strong individuals who have remained resilient in the face of isolation and lack of routine. You have remained focused in completing your tasks, and you have become consciously aware of our world's unfolding crisis. If there is any group of individuals who are ready for what lies ahead, it is the graduating class of 2020. I hope you are so proud of your accomplishments. Your church family here at WPC is very proud. In 2015, Denzel Washington gave a commencement speech at one of the universities, as celebrities often do. He had two strong suggestions within that speech that I would like to share. The first is to put God first in whatever you do, just as others have done in helping you get to where you are today. I would like to add that whether it began with baptism, Sunday school, confirmation, prayer, or service, you had been invited and even encouraged by your parents and church family to get to know God and begin a relationship with him that could last a lifetime. His second suggestion from that speech is that before you go to bed each night, place your slippers a bit farther under the bed. Do this so that every morning when you get out of bed to fetch them, you will have to get down on your knees. While you are down on your knees, thank God for all you have. Thank God for grace and mercy, understanding and kindness, parents and loved ones, peace, prosperity, humility. Thank God as so many have thanked him for you. We thank God for you and the journey that lies ahead. Dr. Seuss wrote a book entitled, Oh, the Places You Will Go. I find it most relevant for you high school graduates. I hope you enjoy your copy. This book transcends age. It is the story of the yet-to-be-visited, yet-to-be-seen, and yet-to-be-experienced. There is also a part about meeting new people. Did you know God has been with you on the already-visited, already-seen, and already-experienced adventures of your journey thus far? He probably went humbly unnoticed for a large part. As you move into the next phase of your life, I want to invite you to consciously pause and acknowledge God's presence, just like the slippers under the bed, even if only to yourself. God is there whether you think you have invited him or not. He so happens to be an excellent travel companion. He packs light and he doesn't take up space. He is an excellent listener and is an amenable to your will. He will challenge you at times so you become a more informed traveler on your journey. He will both encourage and comfort and never judge. He is the greatest travel companion. Oh, the places you will go with God by your side. Isaiah chapter 58, verse 11 tells us, "The Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land and will strengthen your frame. You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters will never fail." Congratulations, class of 2020. Your WPC family will be here to welcome you home and look forward each time you return. We have included a few brief messages of congratulations and hope from your peers.
Hi, seniors. On behalf of everyone from WPC, congratulations on your well-deserved success. We are so proud of you and excited to see the journeys you will take in the future. It is my hope that you put yourself out of your comfort zone at your new home and try new things. I hope you make many new memories with your new friends that will soon feel like family. A Bible verse I would like to share with you is from John chapter 14, verse 27. Peace I leave with you, my peace I give you. I do not give to you as the world gives. Do not let your heart be troubled, and do not be afraid. WPC can't wait to see where life will take you next, and wherever it is, our prayers go with you. May you always dare to do great things. Congrats, seniors. We're so proud.
Hi, WPC seniors. Congratulations on graduating. Although the circumstances weren't ideal, just know WPC is so proud of you, and you should be proud of yourself.
You guys have so much to look forward to in these upcoming years at your colleges and beyond. Just know that WPC is always here for you, and we really appreciate every single one of you.
Here's a Bible verse we would want to share with you from Mark chapter 10, verse 27. Jesus looked at them and said, "With man this is impossible, but not with God. All things are possible with God."
We are so proud of you, and just know while you're on your journeys, WPC will always be here for you and support you, and we will welcome you with open arms when you guys return home.
Hello, WPC friends. I miss seeing you. It's nice to be with you this morning. And congratulations to all of our seniors graduating. So our prayer this morning will be a responsive one, and I'll need your help. So when I pray, Lord of Mercy, your response will be, hear our prayer. So, Lord of Mercy, hear our prayer. Let's come together now, bowing our heads before the God of all creation. Holy God, we know you hear us when we call your name. And so we cry out to you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit, Creator, Sustainer, Waymaker, Light in the Darkness, Holy God. Before we ask you for anything, we thank you for everything. We thank you for the children in our congregation who have grown up before our eyes and who are now reaching the milestone of graduation. Some from high school, some from college, we give you praise for each one, for the individual qualities that make each child unique and precious in your sight. Shower your blessing on your graduates, granting them your steady presence with each step they take. In your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer. Holy God, we bring our full selves to you this morning, admitting our brokenness as a people. We do not know how to love each other. We react, we judge, we stereotype, and we devalue each other, especially our brothers and sisters with darker skin than our own. Forgive us, God, for our collective sin and our individual sin. Teach us to see each other through the eyes of Jesus. Show us how to be people of moral integrity in our families, in our workplaces, standing up for the dignity of all people. In your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer. Holy God, we bring to you our fears, our anxiety about what will happen next, our loneliness, our exhaustion, our self-doubt, our physical and emotional wounds. Pour out your healing balm on us, Lord. Carry us when we are weak. Lift us when we are low. Heal us when we are sick. Holy Spirit, we pray for our loved ones now who are struggling in mind and body. We name their names aloud in your presence, requesting your healing power. In your mercy, Lord, hear our prayer. And so we come to you together as a body, praying the faithful prayer that Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Thank you.
The litany for Holy Communion this morning comes from an adapted litany written by the Reverend Marin Tirabassi. You're invited to Holy Communion with the body of Christ. That body of Christ is not the loaf of bread you see on my plate or on your screen. The body of Christ is not even the bread on your table. The body of Christ is us. As we are strengthened by sharing together this meal of hope and grace and presence. The parables on the table this morning include a mask and a glove, symbols of care of the body of Christ. As Jesus might have said, the realm of God is like a mask of compassion on the bread of heaven and a gloved hand lifting up the cup of blessing so that all might be served and safe. We pause to honor and to consecrate with love for all God's children the many holy tables in our church homes. We are the body of Christ dispersed and gathered at the same time, which is always true, though we don't always see it. In your many kitchens and living rooms, rest your hands lightly upon these elements, which we set aside today to be a sacrament. And let us ask God's blessing upon them and upon us and upon all those who were in our prayers this morning. For it was on the night that Jesus was betrayed that he took bread and he broke it and he said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And in the same manner, after supper, he took the cup and he said, This is the cup of the new covenant shed for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in forgiveness, in remembrance of me. For every time that you eat this bread and you drink this cup, you proclaim the death of the Lord until he come again. Gentle host, rest upon us as you rested upon water and light and earth and creatures, human beings all in your image and holy Sabbath. Send your spirit of life and love, power and blessing upon your children who are staying at home so that this bread may be broken and gathered in love and this cup poured out to give hope to all. Risen Christ, live in us that we may live in you. Breathe in us that we may breathe in you. Amen. As you share the elements around your own tables in your own homes, we will hear Mary Jo Duffy sing the beloved hymn, On Eagle's Wings. My friends, the gifts of God for the people of God.
Fall about you, near you it shall not come. given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will raise you up, lest you cast your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings,
thanksgiving for this meal of grace, rejoicing that in the holy dispersion of virtual worship, we claim the risen Christ's love is not limited by buildings made with human hands, nor contained in human ceremonies. O Holy One, our tongues have tasted the good news, and our lives are filled with the Spirit that hovered over creation and blew fresh hope on Pentecost. Creator, open our hearts. Word, speak peace in our voices to all the people in all the hot spots and hurts of the world. As we journey masked through our lonely or dangerous or overbusy day, Holy Spirit, fill us with this blessing that it is good. Amen. We thank all of those who participated in this morning's service today. For our younger people, Maggie Rowe and Shannon Rowe, for Kathryn Stein, for Julie Fowler and her efforts to honor our graduates, including putting out signs in front of each of our high school graduates' homes and delivering goodie bags to each of them. For Mary Jo Duffy and Al Galletly, Margaret Carkner and Jessica Jones, who read the prayers of the people. And thank you again to my daughter, Peyton White, who did the videography and editing for this service. If you'd like to give to Wilton Presbyterian Church, you may do so by going online at our website, wiltonpresbyterian.org, and there's a give button in the upper right-hand corner. You can give a secure donation there and get an immediate receipt. Or you may mail a check into the church. You're checking mail regularly. And we're very, very grateful for your continuing generosity. Julie Fowler will give a closing prayer for our graduates, and I will come back for a benediction. Julie.
Pray with me. Heavenly Father, thank you today for James, Anna, Lindsay, Patrick, and Carl, who are off to college. We also thank you for Tucker, John, and Anna, who have completed their undergraduate degrees and now seek their fulfillment and dreams in a big world. Lord, please let your light illuminate the path for these graduates, both in life and faith. We ask that you serve as their compass so they may always find their way. Please shelter them in times of storm and be their wings at times of flight. Lift them up to give them courage to continue to do your work, and may your love be the foundation for their greatness. In Jesus' name we pray, amen.
Go forth on this day, brothers and sisters, bringing the light and peace and love of God to all. And may the blessing of Creator, Sustainer, and Holy Spirit be with each and every one of us now and forevermore. Amen.